Hey guys, what's up? It's Apollo, and welcome to another historical battle in Middle-earth. This, of course, is a custom scenario in Third Age Total War, and this is the Siege of Lothlórien. It takes place during the War of the Ring, around the same time of the Siege of Minas Tirith. And if you haven't read the books, then you probably don't know that multiple places in Middle-earth is under attack, under assault by Sauron. So you've got Minas Tirith, you've got Lothlórien, I think Cariandros, and then I think Dale is under attack by a bunch of Easterlings. So I highly recommend that you read the books because it goes into great detail, and it's just a completely different experience. So in this battle, of course, you've got Galadriel and you have Celeborn, and they are fighting together with their elves. Also, the Ents are teaming up with the elves, so you got Treebeard. He's got about 200 Ents present in this battle, but unfortunately, there is no Ents in this version of the fight. And the attackers, you've got a massive force. You've got a mix of orcs from Dol-Guldur. So we've got Gundabad representing Dol-Guldur right here. So here's his army. And then over here, you have the forces of Mordor. So look at this army ready to take the forest of Lothlórien. And then you have the orcs of Moria, which makes sense because Moria is really close to the forest of Lothlórien. So the battle was pretty decisive for the elves because Galadriel is just really OP and she just wrecks lives. Also, the Ents are really strong and hard to kill. So they destroyed the invasion force and actually grouped up with the elves of Mirkwood and then later attacked Dol-Guldur, which we've actually already done the battle scenario for that one. So if you want to watch these in order, be sure to check out Dol-Guldur after this one. And of course, that was also a elven victory. Galadriel was just too strong and she used her like tornado powers and destroyed everything. So let's go ahead and look at the army comps and begin this fight. I forgot one of the really cool things about this battle is that the Rohirrim show up. Yes, the Rohirrim do send some forces to aid them in their struggle. So that's something that's really cool. So let's now finally look at the army comps. We'll start with the elves. And by the way, this is the capital of Lothlórien, which is pronounced, I hope I don't slaughter it, Caras Galadhon, I think. That's what I'm going to go with. That's how I say it in my head. But it's this great area where Galadriel and Celeborn live. But here's the first army commanded by Paladin Bob. And of course, this is a custom scenario made by Paladin Bob. So thank you, Paladin. This looks beautiful. I cannot wait to watch this one. So he's got some swordsmen and, of course, some spears. Just a nice, strong army. You got the Silvan heavy archers. More spears over here. It looks like this is kind of like the last defense, ready to defend their great capital. And then over here, let's see, we've got Kauchka, or Kauchka, who's also commanding one of the elven armies. He also has some Silvan elves, light elven archers. Looks like they're kind of defending the outskirts of Lothlórien. There's a lot of great, look at this, does this not look like a forest? You've got a lot of great terrain and positioning that you can use against your opponents. But also there's more armies that are a part of Paladin Bob's army. So we got more forces on the outskirts. I just forgot to show you these guys, but here they are. They look pretty cool. It looks like they're going to face the forces over here, which is pretty ballsy from them. And then Kauchka is controlling some of the horsemen from Rohan, but he can't activate them until 10 minutes after the battle begins because they are a reinforcement that shows up a little bit later. So let's go ahead and now check out the evil forces. We'll start with Mordor, commanded by Jokadale. Just a classic Mordor army, lots of orc raiders, trolls, catapults, and there were a lot of trolls present in this fight. We've got Uruks over here. Very intimidating looking. Looks like we got some halberds as well. And the next army we're going to look at is from Dol-Guldur. So here is Dol-Guldur, commanded by Untamed Wolf. He's got some orc halberdiers, he's got orc fellers, here's some trolls, some mountain trolls. And let's see, some orc band or goblin band. Snaga stalkers. Here's his orc bodyguard and here is his general. Oh, look at this, we got some wargs and snow trolls as well. And the final army that we're going to look at is, let's see, the orcs of Moria. So a lot of goblins, goblin infantry, heavy goblin infantry. These guys look so cool. I always talk about it, but they do look stunning. And we've got halberds over here. So, massive army. It's going to be pretty tough. You look at the balance of power. It's not exactly in favor of the elves, but they've got a lot of great positioning. The forest are going to aid them in this fight. So, we'll see how this turns out. So, the armies are pretty far apart. So, I'm going to just go ahead and fast forward until we get to some action here. Right now, we see the elves positioning up on this hill. So, you've got some forces over here in the forest. Now, I will be doing a lot of close-ups in this battle because it's kind of hard to see what's going on with all the trees in the way. So, I'll be sure to zoom in like this, which it will be pretty cool seeing armies just come out of nowhere in the forest. But yeah, there's a little bit of a skirmish from these Silvan Horse archers. And Lothlorien is actually one of my favorite parts of the Fellowship in the book. There's something about it because, you know, you read about them going through the mines of Moria, Gandalf dies, and then finally they get to Lothlorien, and it's just this weird, mysterious place, and I really just enjoy the characters in it, like Haldir and Galadriel. I think Galadriel's a really interesting character. But yeah, anyways, now I got my nerd info out. So there is a little bit of a back and forth. I think, let's see, the forces of Dol Guldur are not going to engage up on that hill, which is probably pretty smart, because he wants to try to maneuver his army and go up this way, because he wants to attack the capital. Look at all the force they have to run through to get to the capital. That's pretty intense, pretty crazy. And the forces over here are still kind of waiting around. Looks like Kachka has sent over his army to also aid the defense of the capital. So let's head back here. This is so cool. Like, the forest, it just, the size of the map is intense. Okay, guys, welcome back. So I decided to cut it a little bit because really what's going on is just a massive march of these giant armies of orcs. And there is a little bit of a, you know, skirmish battle going on with the Cav. But again, you weren't really missing much. They charged in once. They got a couple volleys off. But really, it's nothing. It's nothing really to, you know, to see. Oh my god, do you see the catapults firing up in the forest? Looks like he's trying to weaken his defense there. We do have one unit of spears protecting one unit of archers. So this is a brave stand. It's some forces resisting the forces of evil. So let's see, what do we have going up here? Oh, there goes another catapult volley. Let's see where that's headed. Yeah, there's a lot of forest, guys. I hope you guys don't mind, but, you know, to make it feel authentic. This is the forest of Lothlórien. I mean, there's gonna be trees. Lots and lots of trees. Alright, see, what do we got here? Oh, we got the wargs going up. And be sure to use the mini-map, because that will give you a great view of what's going on. Because it is going to be hard to get those bird's-eye view. Oh, the catapult actually getting a hit there on the elves. So you've got the catapults of Mordor. Here comes another round, another volley. Oh, maybe not. But the wargs are free to run down these archers. I don't know if he's not paying attention here, but they are going to take a pretty big hit. And Paladin and Bob's forces are now engaged in melee against the great warg riders. And they're actually doing all right. These sentinels of the Woodland Realms, they're actually pretty damn solid. And it looks like they've got some heavy armor. There goes another charge by another warg unit. Oh, that warg got wrecked. And we do have a couple spears over here fighting off the wargs. The catapults are continuing to fire up this hill. And the elves are falling back to protect their archers. And this is like a nice little fort defense. You know, like a secondary defense to the capital. There goes another charge into the archers. So just to give a little recap, remember guys that the capital, you see the great trees over there? That is the capital, and this is where the fighting is taking place right here. So he's just being pretty pretty aggressive with his wargs, trying to do some cycle charges, trying to cut down these archers. But even though he is getting some pretty good charges off, he's not exactly killing them. These guys are holding their ground. They've got their nice elven blades just slaughtering these wargs. There we go. And, oh, we even have the sentinel or the horse archers joining the fight. And that breaks the wargs. They've had enough, and they're going back to Moria. See what's going on over here now. There's another little bit of a hill defense over here. Elves holding their, you know, protecting their forest of Lothlórien. Light elven archers firing. You've got some spears forming Shelltron formation, and you've got the Forest Wardens. These units are very, very good, especially if you've been watching my Tug of War series. The Forest Wardens are actually pretty good at killing even dwarves, so they should have a pretty good job, or they should do a pretty good job against the orcs of Gundabad. Okay guys, so I made a little cut there again, so the armies were just pushing forward, and it looks like they're finally pursuing down the spearmen, and it looks like they're evacuating the area, so he is trying to run his spears out of the position. But look at this, you got angry orcs just running through the forest, trying to get to them, and they actually do catch up to the spears, and they're getting caught out, and they have to fight for their life now. A very, very, very bold stand of the Silvan Heavy Spearmen against the forces of Gundabad. Or Dogoldor. Gundabad representing Dogoldor. We also have more forces over here, some orc fellers flanking around. So that's going to be pretty good. He's going to support his other orcs. And they should be able to cut down these spearmen pretty quick. The rest of the forces are climbing up this hill. Looks like they're going to take care of the elves that are still stationed up here. Let's see, where are they? Where are the elves? I'm like with the orcs over here. I'm like, where are they? Where are these damn elves? Oh, here they are. Here they are. Oh, man, look at this. They're holding off a horde of orc fellers. And they're about to get surrounded. See, this is the risky thing about trying to fight off or defending too much area, because if you defend everything, you really defend nothing. But the spears are now surrounded. Defeat seems certain. Pretty nasty fight. It's just a swarm of orcs around the very elite spearmen. Let's see what else is going on here. We do have some forces pushing up this way. Oh yes, we got some wargs charging into the sentinels of the woodland realms. So he's starting to thin down their defense, but the spears will continue to hold this pathway. We've got a mix of forces from Paladin Bob and Kachka 23. Actually, it looks like this is mostly Kachka's forces. So the forces of Mordor, they're really going to have to rely on their catapult if they're going to take this position. See more wards waiting over here. It looks like they're slowly gaining control of the outskirts of the forest. Here we are. Yes. Cut them down, boys. Oh, victory seems certain now. How is that even possible? It's still a unit of 65, these brave elves. They're like, for Galadriel! For Frodo! For Gandalf! It's pretty cool, these battles and like the massive forest. Because it really blocks your vision. So units could really just come out of nowhere and attack you. So he's down to 51 now. It says actually it says victory is almost a certainty. Wow. That's impressive. I mean, great. I don't know how that can be. You're completely surrounded. Now you got wards coming in. There we go. Now it says the balance of forces are evenly matched. For Lothlórien, men! Lothlórien! We will not bend to the will of Sauron. Man, they're holding. Now it says victory is almost a certainty. This is insane. What is going on? Look at all the orcs dying to the blades of the elves. See, the elves have killed 11%. And the orcs have killed 12%. Now it says defeat seems certain. Finally, the number of the orcs are just wearing down the elves. And even with their skill, it's not enough. But what do we have over here? It looks like we got more elves down this way. Remember, guys, use the mini-map to try to look and see what's going on. There is a little bit of a battle taking place here. We got the Forest Wardens taking on the Orc Halberdiers. And also, we've got a fight over here. It looks like the forces of Mordor are well prepared for the horsemen of the Riddimark. So it's been about 10 minutes. Now it might seem shorter than that because I cut through some of the beginning of this battle. But look at this army of Mordor. This is so, I just love it with the trees in there mixed in with this army. It's so intimidating. So yeah, if I was the riders of the Riddimark, I was like, oh no, I'm not taking on this army alone. But he is using his horse archers. Try to skirmish them down a little bit. Arrows flying through the air. We've got the heavy lancers waiting in reserve. All right, so let's head back over to the fights in the outskirts of the battle. We've got trolls now just crushing some elven archers. And look at the background. You see that? You've got a storm of troops pouring down. This battle is all over the place. It is all over the place. Come on, Orc Halberdiers, get down there. There he goes. Oh, gotta be careful with that catapult. You don't want to kill your own trolls. The Sheltron formation, Paladin Bob holding. He's got more Sylvan spearmen. Look at him charging in. They're like, we know we're gonna die, so we might as well kill as many as we can. We'll bring 10 with us. Each man will kill 10 orcs. That'd be pretty impressive. Oh, that catapult, though. So it seems like the orcs of Gundabad are doing all the heavy lifting so far. Killing the small groups of defenses throughout the forest of Lothlórien. This Sheltron formation is holding, too. Holding very well. See what's going on over here. Some elves are running for their lives. They are not breaking. They're just doing a bit of a tactical retreat. See, what else do we have? Oh, they're regrouping over here. The elves now firing into that huge blob of orcs. And let's see what's going on with Mordor's army. We do have some elven horse archers kind of waiting behind them. Oh, looks like there's a bit of a fight here. But it looks like most of the elves were slaughtered against the orc maulers over there. So Mordor, I'm kind of surprised he's just waiting around to take on the Riders of the Riddimark, the Rohirrim reinforcements. Oh geez, the trolls are pursuing these elves down, trying to silence their bows. Oh, look at this though, some reinforcements coming in. We have not forgotten your defense, elves. The Silvan Horse Archers crushing this unit of orc marauders. I really enjoy battles like this one because it's just, it's so cool to see battles just all over the place. It's really tough to like try to capture all of the action, but still, it is really fun to just have small pockets of fighting because it makes it harder to determine who's going to win the fight. But the Elven Cav and the Riders of the Riddimark, the Rohirrim Cav, it's like for the orcs, they're a real pain. Like they're having a tough time trying to contain that cav. Look at the elves firing through the forest, getting some pretty good hits on the orc band. More forces are coming over to kill the spearmen. They are getting pretty depleted. They're thinning out, but they've killed quite a bit. Look at all the dead orcs surrounding them, and a lot of trolls have died as well. Let's go ahead and get a recap of what's going on over here. There is a little bit of fighting taking place here as well. Let's see. Where is it? It's so hard to see where things are. Where is it? I hear him. Oh, here. It's up here. What do we got over here? Oh, yes. Another brave unit of heavy archers. And they're getting surrounded. Not sure if these guys were here from the beginning or he's pushing forward troops. What is this? Mordor is now pushing up his catapults to help out the orcs of Dol Guldur. And they got to start weakening this defense. We do have forces marching from this defense. I like this. Little position here. Oh, wow. We've got a large army pushing forward. Look at all the elves. Paladin Bob, he's not going to sit back in camp. He is going to push and try to bring death upon these trolls. Now, he needs to be careful because he doesn't want his archers too close to the front lines. But he's going to try to take on these trolls while he can with his very awesome swordsmen. You know, before more orc reinforcements show up. Oh, that catapult just misses those archers. The archers, what are they firing at? What are they firing? That's a long distance. Look at that. They're firing at the troops way over here. That is intense. Let's head back over to this battle now. This small pocket of fighting. Oh, some orcs are breaking from the fight. Sauron's going to be pretty pissed about that. But the Silvan horse archers are just wrecking dreams right now. And they're going for the back of the warband. What? What? That was a weird charge. Oh my god. They just got slaughtered. Absolutely slaughtered. And the orc band are like, oh, well, I guess elves are running through us. We'll just kill them. Like, they weren't even phased at all. Here's the last of those archers going toe-to-toe with the orc band. Orc band obviously going to win this fight. Some cav coming over to save them, though. I'm surprised this unit is not wavering. They're eager. There we go. And here's a nice charge. Okay, so let's head back over to the other front. The elves might be doing a tactical retreat here. Maybe he's getting a little too ambitious on taking on this hill. And look at all the elves. They're all like spread out running down. Run for your life. Back to the defenses. Back to the capital. Get ready for the final defense. And you got the snow trolls all bloodied up, seeing some action. Ooh. He's like, get out of my way. Get out of my way. Oh, is he going to make it? I'm not sure. But we've got this army now. This was the orcs of Moria. And they are finally getting close to the capital. So look at their army run through the forest. That is so awesome looking. I don't know. There's something so cool about seeing an army run through a bunch of trees. But is there another path they're going to take? No, they're going to fight this one choke point over here. And the forces now regrouping. The archers are letting loose their arrows. Hitting some wargs. And I'm going to mostly focus on this assault over here because that other part of the fight is seems to be dying down. Oh, there we go. He gets a charge off on Paladin Bob. See, you know, I think Paladin Bob is just so busy with fighting on the other areas. He did not realize about his archers getting attacked like this. And that's one of the main problems of trying to defend on multiple areas. Just like trying to micro everything, make sure they live. Oh yes, so awesome. Trolls right in the middle of the ranks of the elves. Oh, and then you got the catapult firing at the men over here. Oh, going for the archers, I like it. Oh, the trolls are getting cut up. That is very nice, very awesome. And the archers of Snaga archers are now firing back. This is good. I'm glad that they actually do have some archers that they can use to try to weaken their defense. And again, remember guys, they're going to need those catapults to try to weaken the defense of the elves. And I think he's actually going to push some infantry. Yeah, I'm not really sure why he pushed forward the snow trolls by himself. Usually what you want to do with your trolls is push them forward with some infantry so they can kind of work together. But now they are pushing forward the goblin infantry. And it's going to be a tough fight for them against these elves. And the siege of Lothlórien is getting desperate. Oh, but this is so good for these archers. Look at the river of goblins over here. Arrow to the knee, really clumping up his forces. And he's taking a lot of casualties. A lot of casualties. Look at all those arrows. It is insane. Jeez. The forest is... Oh! No! He's using his catapult. This is the worst area to use his catapult. He's gonna get a lot of friendly fire. In fact, that one volley was pretty much all friendly fire. Come on, spread out your forces. Don't do this. Don't let one unit of elven heavy spearmen kill your men. Oh my god. Yeah, he should focus on the archers in the back here. I mean, look at the layers of archers. And the balance of power is still way in favor of the orcs. Here we go. We got more troops running into the front, taking on the other sides of the defense. Come on, spread out your men. Spread them out. I guess he noticed a weak spot in their defense. There is a little bit of a gap here, but he needs to push through it, and he needs to kill the elven defenders. Maybe try to get behind them. And the catapult is just going crazy over here. Not really getting a lot of good hits, but eventually they will. Here comes the orc band. Alright, so real quick, let's look back over here and see what's happening. Through the forest, there is a small pocket of fighting. The spearmen are still holding on, these brave, brave spearmen, but they will be crushed very soon. And then also we've got the Rohirrim up on this hill. I think he's saving them for a little bit better of a situation. So maybe he's gonna wait until the orcs completely push, and then he can attack from behind. But holy crap, look at a bird's eye view of this fight right here. Oh my god, look at all that friendly fire. That is terrible. Terrible. And now the timer is halfway through, so they only have half time now, the rest of this battle, to take the settlement. I'm not sure the time limit for this one. It might be like 45 minutes or something like that. Oh, that catapult. They need to get the catapult closer or something. And they need to stop running their wargs into spears. Oh, this is a nasty defense. Oh my goodness. Yeah, be sure not to clump up your troops, guys. This is not good. It looks really cool, but look at all the dead orcs from arrows, elven arrows, just piercing their armor. Oh my god, the friendly fire is too much. But they are slowly breaking through their defenses. And the elves are breaking from the front lines. Now you got the archers engaged in melee. Yeah, I definitely think the orcs were trying to concentrate on this position to break through. But I still think he should have sent more forces to take on the spears over here. You got some floating dead orcs here. Rest in peace. Just another day of Third Age. These spears are so good at holding the line. Here comes a troll. Never mind, he gets shot in the back with some arrows and he falls. Let's see what he's got left of this defense. Oh, look at this, guys. This is really cool. You got the archers, you got some spears over here. And that's about it. You do have a... I guess this is Galadriel, or no, since it's a guy, I assume it's Celeborn. Galadriel's just off doing elven things. I don't know what she's doing. Smoking a doobie? Who knows? Who knows? Oh my god, look at the horde of orcs pushing through the forest. And not only are they destroying the elves, but they are destroying my frame rates as well. The halberdiers, the goblin halberdiers, they look so cool. I love seeing the polearm units with their weapons like up in the air. Oh, and there goes one of the generals. I think that's the general for the Misty Mountains there, the orcs of the Misty Mountains. We get the catapults in the background getting closer and closer. And the balance of power is slowly shifting back in favor of the elves, but it is very much in favor of the orcs here. And they are just getting schooled by those arrows. Got a brave stand of sentinels of the woodland realm. Got their blades out. It's time to hold for the capital of Lothlórien. So, yeah, the orcs in the Misty Mountains, they are pushing, and they are making some headway, but they lost so many good soldiers. They could have prevented it, too. But it is really cool to see their mass numbers push up this hill. Look at all of them. Look at all the dead orcs over here. This is stupid insane. See, this is what I mean. Don't clump up your troops, especially against elven archers. But he is making progress. He needs to surround these troops over here. These troops will bite him in the butt. Like, literally, they will flank around and kill these forces from behind. Oh my god, the lag is real. The lag is real. I'm sorry, guys, about that. Catapult now firing into the defense of the elves. Yeah, I'm actually kind of glad they didn't have ints, because ints would have made it just way too easy. But I assume he's pushing really hard for the capital because of the timer. You know, it's running out here. I mean, he still has a good amount of time, but he just wants to be careful and he doesn't want to run out of time. Nice stand of the Sentinels of the Woodland Realm. Ooh, we got some pretty vicious artillery going into the archers over here, trying to get some archer kills. Archers firing way up into the air. Arrows crashing down into this big blob of troops. Now the good news for the orcs of Moria is that they're protected by the trees. So they are saving some lives by staying under the trees. Now we have elven archers holding the line. Let's see, the spears still not being flanked. And they're going to do a great job of keeping back these orcs. The catapults and... Oh my god, look at all the reserves over here. Oh, but wait! The Rohirrim! They have striked. They are attacking the back of their lines. Mordor is pissed. He's got his Uruks trying to protect his men. And now the brave riders of the Riddermark are going to run back into the forest, into the shadow, try to get more cycle charges off. But Mordor is not going to let that happen. He's going to continue to pursue them down. There he goes. But they are going to safely escape. Here comes a counter charge. Just trying to weaken their numbers just a little bit. So many orcs. Brave Rohirrim. Fear no darkness. So here's a bird's eye view of the situation. Climbing up this hill. Trying to contain the cav. He is taking a lot of casualties here. Oh my god, look at all these orcs. All the orcs. Oh, he's even got the trolls pursuing them down. So this is definitely... Oh, look at this charge! Counter charge! This is definitely buying some time for the elves defending the capital. Oh, what was that? Someone used a special ability. Keep the morale going. Lots of screaming going on here. Uruks getting hit hard by these great horse masters. Yeah, so they're going to continue to run back and forth and get cycle charges. Let's go back to the front lines, to the capital over here. Let's see where the... Oh, wow. What is going on? We've got more riders of the Riddermark running down the forces. It must have had a huge chain route. I think he got a really great flank there. And now the balance of power is even. It is even. And these elves are pushing back, taking back their forest. forces of Mordor, or this is Gundabad, trying to join back in the battle, trying to reconquer their lands that they've lost so far in this fight. It's just like chaos everywhere. It's just like fighting all throughout this forest. It's ridiculous. Yeah, they're just ripping through these orcs. I mean, they're really depleted and tired at this point. And there goes another general, the Rohirrim, running them down. We do have some fighting up on this hill. Got a lot of Uruks over here, though. It's a massive army. I mean, this is far from over. Look at all the death and destruction over in this one area. And look at this. Okay, if you zoom out a little bit, you see the dead orcs there? Look at that. And the spears stand victorious over their dead. Over the conquered dead. There goes another cycle charge. We even have the general coming out to fight. And there goes the last general for the attacking forces. And their morale is really going to suffer. And the elves might actually be able to hold on, but they don't want to get too aggressive. Here comes a charge from the orc maulers. Big axe unit going after the elven general. Oh, they broke? How did they break? A unit of 182 breaks. What in the world? Here we go. March of the elves pushing forward. The riders of the Riddermark running down the breaking soldiers. What is this army doing? I guess he's really concerned about the horsemen. I don't know why they're so far away from the fight. They should be supporting their other orcs over here that are getting slaughtered. Yeah, they're just running them down. Completely running them down. So hopefully you guys learned a little bit about not clumping up your troops. You never want to do that. They just got slaughtered. Look at all the... Here's a good point of view of this. Look at this. If you get it right at the right angle, look at all those dead orcs. It is nasty. All the way up to the capital of Lothlórien. And, using those bows, it was just a massive slaughter on those poor orcs. There's nothing he could have done. I wish they took it a little bit more patient. But look at this right over the hill. Here comes the elves. Or under the hill. They appear on top of the hill. And this is the final push. Mordor's final stand. I think the horsemen for Rohirrim have pretty much died. Here comes another charge here. From some spearmen. Got a thin line of elves. They probably should send more reinforcements up here. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Here comes more elves. Uh-oh. What is that? Oh, no. I can't see. I think it was an elven general. Possibly. Celeborn. You're not supposed to die here. I love that rally. Always helps the battle just feel more epic, more authentic. Here comes more elves charging up the hill. So I imagine that they're feeling very confident in their defense. The fact that they're being so aggressive, trying to take out this final grouping of Uruks. Oh, we've got some forces over here now. They got them surrounded a little bit. Oh, that is so cool looking. And this small pocket of fighting taking place over here as well. Got some trolls engaged. But the balance of power is way in favor of the elves. So I think they're going to take this one. I think they're going to take it. This is so cool though, this fight right here, it's just awesome. So like close and intense. There's that elven rally. Victory today. Lothlorien is safe. Lothlorien. Yeah, it is. It's pretty sad that Lothlórien gets attacked because, like I said earlier in this video, Lothlórien is like one of my favorite places in Middle Earth. Just seems very lovely, very safe place. But there we go. The Uruks are starting to get shaken there, but they are not stirred and they're still fighting. But defeat seems almost certain for them. Elves cutting down this troll here. Even the tree's like taking him on. There we go, he's slain. And the rest of the elves running down the remaining forces. And the attackers made a lot of big mistakes there. I feel like if the orcs of Moria didn't clump up his forces too much, if he spread them out a little bit more, if they were a little bit more cautious with their catapult, I think they could have easily taken this one. I really do. Oh, what's that? A little fear ability there? There we go, massive chain route. And that's going to be it for them. And that is going to be the battle. So, yes, Haldir was in this fight, Celeborn. Both players getting a ton of kills. I'm not sure who's who. I assume Celeborn is Paladin Bob getting 4,000 kills. And Kachka getting 3,373. If we look on the other side, we have Mordor getting 813. Ooh, this is what I'm talking about. Moria only getting 229 kills. And then we have Gundabad getting 711 kills. So just like the real battle, this is a very decisive victory for the elves and the Ents and the Rohirrim. And later, Galadriel and the forces of the elves will meet up with the elves in Mirkwood, and they will retake Dol Guldur. And if you guys want to watch that battle, there's a link in the description. It's a really good battle. Another great custom scenario by Paladin Bob. So thank you, Paladin Bob, and thank you for you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this battle. It was pretty crazy, pretty intense. There's a lot of forests, and I know you guys don't really like forest battles, but I thought it was pretty cool. Pretty cool. So, alright guys, I'm going to end it here. Thank you once again for watching. Here's the stats, if you want to look at that. Oh, wait, did I just see a unit get 400 kills? Yes, I did. 420. The archers. That is ridiculous. But yeah, we'll end it here. Thanks, guys, and I'll see you next time.